Suppose I have this resistance having a value R, and the voltage at this terminal is V1 and voltage at this terminal V2, then what will be the current flowing through this resistance? The current flowing through this resistance will be V1 minus V2, if the current is moving in this direction, divided by R. Now what's going to happen if V1 is equal to V2? If V1 is equal to V2, I will be equal to 0. So, if no current flows through a circuit, then the two terminals of that particular circuit will have the same potential. So, this is very important. If no current flows through a circuit, the two ends will be at same potential. Now, let's use this particular concept for operational amplifier. We know that operational amplifier has input impedance equal to infinite. What is impedance? Basically, impedance is nothing but resistance, but it is used for AC signals. So whenever you say that, whenever you talk about the resistance of AC signal, you call it as impedance. And this resistance basically varies with frequency. So if I change the frequency, the resistance change, and that's why it is called as impedance, not resistance. So for input impedance is infinite, so it means that across these two input terminals, there is no amount of current is flowing. So because of that, if I ground one particular terminal of this operational amplifier, let's suppose this is non-inverting terminal, this is inverting terminal, and I grounded non-inverting terminal, and I am using a feedback. Let's say I am using a negative feedback. I applied a voltage of V in over here. Since no current flows through these two terminals, the potential at this particular point, since it is connected to ground, is 0 volt. Let me call it as A point. And this particular point, let me call it as B. And let me connect a resistance so that it makes some sense. Okay. So, what will be the potential at point B? Now, if I magnify the circuit, I'm going to have something like this. This is my input impedance. This is a non-inverting terminal. This is an inverting terminal. And the potential over here is 0 volt. Right? And since there is no current flowing through this, since this resistance is infinite, there will be no amount of current flowing through it. And since there is no amount of current flowing through it, this terminal should be obviously at a potential of 0 volt. Correct? This particular concept. So, this implies that the potential at this particular point will also be equal to 0 volt. This particular concept is known as concept of virtual ground. Now, let's talk a little bit about it more. Now, suppose I have this circuit. This is point A and this will be point B, and I have applied voltage V in. What will be the voltage at a point B? Now initially, if I have a resistance Rin and there is no current flowing through this resistance, as you know that if this is point A and this is point B, then VA is equal to VB. Why? Because there are no current flowing through the circuit, and as we discussed, in the case of resistance, if there is no current flowing through a resistance, then the two terminals of the resistance should be at the same potential. Now, if I apply this analogy over here, this terminal is at voltage of 1 volt. So, since there is no current flowing through the input terminals, then this terminal also has to be at a voltage of 1 volt. Then, can somebody tell me what will be the current flowing through a resistance R1? So now if I have a resistance, then the current flowing through this resistance will be equal to, and if I applied, let's say, plus V over here and minus V minus over here and V plus over here, this is the resistance R1, then current flowing through this will be V plus minus V minus, that is the potential difference across the resistance divided by value of this resistance. So the current flowing through this R1, let me call it as IR1, this R1 will be equal to V in minus VB divided by R1. And similarly, if I want to calculate what is the current flowing through the feedback resistance Rf, this will be equal to, and if I am considering the same direction of current, this will be equal to Vb minus Vout divided by Rf. We'll be using this particular formula from the next video. So hope you understand this particular concept of virtual ground and the concept of feedback. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video.